Hey guys, what's up? Mid-afternoon, my kids are off to school, it's Friday. Time for me to prep dinner. All right, let's do it. I'm gonna share this little easy recipe with you. So what we have here is some leftover chicken. So, you know, this is like what's left over of a chicken after, you know, you take the main two breasts and you leave a little bit of the breast on the carcass, I guess you can call it. And we're gonna make what's called enchilada casserole. So what I did is the chicken was in kind of like, you know, big chunks, and I just got my knife here and just chopped it up into bite size, like small pieces. And I got the enchilada sauce. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna soak this chicken in enchilada sauce. Let's do it. So before you put the sauce on the chicken, you wanna kind of give this a good stir, because settling is naturally occurring. So we stirred that. Okay, let's add like maybe just a third of the can, just enough to kind of flavor the chicken here. And is that about a third? Roughly that's a third. There we go. We'll save the rest of this for, the enchilada casserole itself. So let's just simply put the lid on that, put that in the fridge, cover that. I'm gonna mix this a little bit, and we're gonna like let this kind of just sit in the fridge and kind of marinate. Hey guys, so also, you know, why don't we add a can of black beans into here? Let the beans marinate too, why not? Let's see what happens. So since I at the last minute decided to dump these black beans in, let's add a little bit more sauce in here, just to kind of coat the black beans a little bit. Just a little bit more. All right, now we're gonna stir this around, okay? Now we're gonna let this refrigerate, and it'll be our, you'll see what happens later. Hey guys, so we have all of our elements. We have the rest of our sauce that's been in the refrigerator. We have our bean and chicken, and we have some tortillas. And let's put down a little sauce in the Pyrex here, and we'll lay that down first. All right, so we got our layer of sauce down, and let's go ahead and layer some tortillas. What we got here? Some corn tortillas. We're gonna layer these guys real easy here. Ba-doop. And there we go. And maybe another one. Looks pretty good, I think. Okay. Maybe another one right there. Maybe another one right there. Okay. And now we're gonna layer on this stuff on top of that. All right, guys, so basically you want to kind of layer this, you know, get it all nice and even, kind of spread out, cover that tortilla totally. And you got to keep in mind, we've got a lot of enchilada sauce on here already because the meat's been marinating with the beans and the chicken. The chicken has been marinating with the beans and the sauce. Anyway, there we go. And let's go ahead and add another layer of tortillas. One, and maybe let's break this one in half. Why I want to do that, I'll show you, because I don't want to get too crazy with the corn tortillas. I just want to cover it as a layer. There we go. See? And then we're going to put the rest of this on top. And I think that ought to do it. As you can see, maybe I went a little too heavy in the last layer, but let's put the rest of the sauce on. All right, let's see what happens. Okay. And let's try that. So I just added another layer of tortillas on that. So we can see through our Pyrex that we got sauce, right? Tortilla. Our filling, a little bit more filling and some sauce, and then the last bit here, I'm gonna pour some sauce over this last little bit. Okay. So this should be pretty saucy and good, I hope. And I'm not gonna add cheese or anything on there because my kids don't like cheese on it. I'll add maybe a little bit of cheese on me and my wife's piece. And we'll see how it is when it comes out of the oven. All right, guys, 400 degrees is the temperature we want. We're gonna put this tray of goodness in here for 20 minutes. Okay, so here she is. Enchilada casserole. Why do we make enchilada casserole? Because it's a whole lot easier than rolling up individual enchiladas and you get the same flavor. Okay, yeah. Family, what do you think, Nathan?
I don't know, it's not that spicy.
It's not that spicy?
No.
Is it tasty?
Uh-huh, it's very tasty.
What about you, Fia?
Very, very spicy.
But tasty?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm sorry, I'm garnishing mine.
Mama? Spoon. Oh. Let's see.
Delicioso.
Delicioso?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well,
caliente.
Then it must be good. So, just got done with dinner, the enchilada casserole. My wife makes it much better than I do. Why? Because she uses quite a bit more sauce than I did. So I used a large can of Las Palmas enchilada sauce. What everyone needs to know is they need to use a large can and a small can. And that would be probably the adequate amount because it was a little dry and the mild is too spicy for kids.
It is very, very hot.
It was kind of spicy, but it was good. I think it was good.
Best ever?
Maybe.
Better than Mama's?
Almost.
Not so much, I know. How was the enchilada casserole?
Oh,
that's a mean, loaded question because you didn't get any. Aww.
Whoa.
Dang.